Guys, sorry, okay. I think the process becomes very straightforward. It's the same. It's the same. We keep reading. You know already, like I have already told you, which each table says. The only difference is we can watch here. I have a couple of new operations. For example, I have here a set. It's like, please have a look at each one of these things how I'm calculating. But so here I'm calculating a set as the difference between two sets. Yeah, so I need to calculate the tuple set, which are the stations, which are not first. Yes. But this includes also the vehicles at the path. So I calculate the difference between the station vehicles path and the first station vehicle path, this set. And this set is calculated using this condition, as we are using also a parameter as condition. Also, another interesting set to read is this set S0 potential nodes original vehicle path. This set is very important for the model. This set is this tuple set becomes the domain of a constraint later on. And this set basically what we have are like the mirror node, the original node to the mirror node, but the original nodes are only the potential nodes. Yeah, yes. Vehicle paths. So notice, like, to calculate this, it's quite an interesting process, because where do we have the information if a node is original or not? We have that information in info substations. Yes. Where do we have the information of mirror nodes? In info nodes. Where do we have the information of which are the vehicles that go through each path? In vehicles path, and when we have the information that connects vehicles path and we also need information how we join the vehicles path with the rest of this information, we need the table info node paths. So this is a more complex join in which we have to be joining each of these. So guys, have a closer look to this, and you will understand how you can calculate this table doing multiple joins at the same time. Or maybe I think this is worth it. Let's not be lazy. I think it's worth it to explain you how to calculate that. So let me open PowerPoint and we do this exercise. And also it helps me to understand how this super hyper mega tree works. So we have big table we need to calculate. So we will have here something like, at the end we will have resource node vehicle. Yeah, this is a tuple set of four elements. In order to get the information of all of these, which tables do we need? We need the tables info nodes. We need the table also info nodes, info substations. The table vehicles path. In the table vehicles path. Yes. So the nodes, these nodes come from this table. It's just one of these comes from this original table, infinite ones. But then, over this table, over all the things that we are here, we have here, we need to apply a filter. The filter is two potential destinations. So we have to join these two tables to make the filter. We have to join this table, these two tables, because yes, because we need to apply the filter to potential stations. So we join these tables, and the name of these tables is in the field, in which field? In, so remember that this table has code node one, code node two. Here are like the mirrors, and here are the, in this column we store the originals. And this table in for superstations is just code node. So we made here this join is made in code node one and code node two. It must be in code node one. Code node one is going to code node. In code node are only port, are only original stations. Yes. Then after we do this, we also this information here. So here we do another join, and this is a bit more simple because we don't need any filter. In this way, we only save info vehicles paths. We say that this is both paths. And from this table, we are gonna get the vehicles, let's say, let me think, like for example, from this table, the vehicles, where is the vehicles coming from? Code vehicle is coming from EE. EE is from vehicles path. Yes, so, and path is coming code vehicles, code path from here, and this one is code now. And in the join, we go in path, and we bring all of them. We bring vehicle, code path. Sorry, I'm using an abbreviation for vehicle. This abbreviation for vehicles, code vehicle. I will have code vehicle, code path. Can I use an abbreviation for notes as well? Anyway, so once I have this join, I need to join also with this. So I need to do another join of this with this. How are we gonna do it? Here, remember, we have node nodes, and we may have to make the join with code node two. Yes, because the code node two are the one that describes this. So because of the mirror, so we have made the join. The join is done with code node two. So finally, when we made the join, filtering this, we are bringing code node one, code node two from here, yes, and all of these are joined with vehicle paths from here. Yes, so finally have this one. Okay, let me see if I did that. If we use the same, because there are a couple of different ways to do it. We have this filter code path, so code node two with triple E code node. Yep. And triple E is info node paths. lymphonal stats. Yep. So that's the way I made the join. So guys, also, what other table do we have? We have the table of supplier ranges. This table is very straightforward to read. So we define the columns of the table, we define some instances of the table here, and we say that we are going to read this in Excel. So let's turn on this in Excel, info supplier ranges. Info supplier ranges, let's turn it on here. And let's go back. Let me close this before I get made a mistake. And then we read the parameters. The parameters are associated to this tuple set. So P lower quantity, these are the quantities that specify the discount. This is the discount. Yes, it's a parameter. So remember how do I read a parameter? A parameter, I have to define here the each element of the tuple set associated to this parameter, and then I write what is the parameter inside the table. Yes, and I define E, what is referring to this table. Okay. Okay, here I have another table data nodes, nodes, paths, where is the main distance, the parameter mean distance. So first what I have to do, I have to read the table, then read the set, and then read the parameter. So okay. So I have to deal here a little gem because I need this parameter. Like I need to create this set. This is a set of nodes, nodes, input path. So, and here be careful, no, doesn't refer to the mirror node, but it's just representing the sequence, the sequence. Yeah, so it's representing as for node one, it's previously to code node two. And we are telling that this type of vehicle is going through this type of path, and in this path, this is an existing link. That's what we are saying. And so remember that we don't have the information of vehicles in the path in one table, so we have to make a join with the table vehicles path. Here, you can see info vehicles path with the info north north path, and we have to make the joining path. Okay, let's keep revising, guys. Here we have the sequence. Okay, so here I am exactly reading this. Yes, I'm putting this into the set. Info nodes, nodes, paths. And then I am reading this parameter associated to this. This pflow factor. This is something that I was using in the other model to refer to. To try to do some sensitivity analysis. Let's leave it there, and this factor will be one. So we can keep the consistency in the model of both versions as much as possible. So we are going to calculate some parameters. Yes, for the model, this one is very important. What is the consumption out of the path? So, because I didn't do this, I could have done this in Excel, but I prefer to do it here in Cplex. More simple for me. So the consumption out of the path is the distance out of the path, yes, times the consumption rate of the type of vehicle. That's how I write the consumption out of the path. This parameter is important in the calculation of the inventory balance constraint. This parameter is almost the same, but now remember that we are in the main route, and in the main route, I represent the consumption like in the main segments. Yes, so the consumption in the main route. That's one of the reasons I need to create this set here that makes reference to what is the node, the following node, and what is the vehicle, and what is the path that is traveling through this arc. So it's the distance of this arc, or this is not an arc as we define an arc. This is a segment times the consumption rate of the vehicle. So it's the consumption of the main route. Quantity of vehicles, so remember that before we define this parameter as an auxiliary parameter, and then we here multiply by PW factor, which is in this case one. But this could be useful when we want to make sensitivity analysis and just, okay, what about if the flow of vehicles increased by 2, by 3, by 4, anyway, by whatever. Same concept with the parameter start inventory. Remember that we had defined this parameter, and we are multiplying by a factor, which is 1. Here, I am defining a string, but this string is not useful for the optimization model. This string is useful when we are exporting scenarios. This is for like the output decoration. Guys, and finally, very important, our variables. Yes, so here we have our variables, inventory. Yes, we need to calculate the inventory. It's a variable which is indexed in nodes vehicles path. Yes, what is the inventory of this type of vehicle? We need to arrive at this node while it's traveling through this path. Yes. Refuel quantity is how much has the vehicles refueling a given station while he was traveling through a given path. Refuel, this is a binary variable that says, and look, it's an integer positive variable between 0 and 1. Yes. So for each vehicle traveling through each type of vehicle traveling with different paths in a given station, do I refuel or not? Units of capacity, which and the domain of this variable is only in the ordinance stations. And yes, in my other suppliers, I don't do this. I don't define the capacity and the units of capacity. The location variable 01 if I locate the station or not, the quantity purchased. Quantity purchased in range. The variable of binary variable that say if I purchase in the range of not. And finally, I am using an expression to define the total cost. So, how I am doing that? Yes, minimize total cost. Expression for total discount. Look. This is a little trick. And I do this. Oh, this is wrong, guys. I am assuming the discount. The discount is positive or negative?
This is a mistake. Let me think. Let me see. I want to quickly through this to these sets. I want to see a little bit of these sets before. Let me see. Do I have any execute here? No, I don't have any execute. Guys, okay, let me just quickly check if I have any more supplier ranges. So let me I do this here. I want to see a little bit better supply ranges. I need to open this, all of this, all of this. Everything is open now. Everything is open now. Ranges, how do you read? Okay. I was thinking, I don't need. In any moment, okay, when I say suppliers, that's the only thing I need, I see info substations. In info substations, the suppliers are the only way I need to say that they are my own. So I am okay with this. I have two ranges for these ones. Let me check. Because pads to play ranges, yes, just two ranges. Oh my goodness. I am seeing something weird. But look, these quantities I want to see because they seem not to be right. Number and show me these separators. I don't want to see decimals. Okay. This is fine. So the idea is to have said this, like, okay, I have MVP 20 minions. For this, this has to be a very, very, very big number. And in VR, I have 2 minions. For getting that discount, technically this has to be an infinite number. Is that something wrong or not? Is that a mistake? this could generate mistakes because let me remember the numbers of this. The numbers of this network generation outputs, inputs, in the inputs, which magnitude are we talking about? We are output args, we are input parameters. Okay, the total refrigerant quantity is 1 million liters. So we should be consuming around 1 million liters in the network. So putting that 2 million should be okay. Should be okay. Suppliers. Also for suppliers, I need the minimum purchase quantity. I am reading this table, the master of suppliers. I don't remember to have read this table here. Master of suppliers. Purchase quantity. Okay, yes. Master of suppliers. My suppliers, so that's good. Let's keep revising this. This is. Okay, that's good, that's all right. So let's keep revising. Let's revise this expression. So I define a variable total cost. Yes, this is a way to define the objective function. Yes, I'm going to say the objective function minimize this. And then in a constraint, I'm going to say total cost is equal to this. Why this trick? Because I want to see how this the objective function is expanding itself. Yes, and when I mean why the objective function is expanding itself is because I want to see the LP file associated to that module. Have here total refilling costs. Yes, what is the total refilling cost? Is the following is one component of the cost is the price times the refilling quantity. But remember that when I say price times refilling quantity, I'm saying okay, the liter is $1 times the refilling quantity, that type of vehicles in that path in that station. Refuel 100 liters. Yes, but remember that it was not just one vehicle, it was many vehicles, all the vehicles of the same type that go through that path. And I am doing this summation. So this first term is representing the refueling cost. So one bit of the cost is the price. The other bit of the refueling cost is the opportunity cost. Each time that I stop, it's time of the driver of the vehicle making that operation. So there is an opportunity cost associated to the time the vehicle is spending. But also there is a cost associated to the deviation to go to refuel. If the station is very far, the vehicle will be consuming, apart from fuel, other type of costs. Yes, and that's why we say two times the variable cost, because it goes and comes back. And remember that the distance out of the path is just the distance to go to the station, and we assume symmetric, the distance to go is the same to come back. And we multiply here by the binary variable. Good. By the binary variable, that's it. This is the total refueling cost. Then I have the total location cost, and the total location cost are two terms. Yes. For the stations that are potential, if I locate the station, I have to pay for the location. This is like kind of investment costs. But also, associated to location costs are the capacity costs, if I increase the capacity. Yes, so this cost is associated to the cost of one unit of capacity times the quantity of units of capacity. And this cost applies for all our own stations. They have the potentials to be modified. So I have here the total discount, and the total discount is the discounts times the quantity that I purchase in the range. And remember that the discount is in the range, and the quantity I purchase in range is going to be only one associated to one supplier. Remember that we are using the index L to refer to the suppliers, and G to refer to the ranges. So the quantity purchased in range times the discount. And I want to see if the discount is positive or negative. The discount. I am defining the discount is positive or negative. So supplier ranges, the discount is a positive number. So, and all of, I did this because here I have a mistake. Here I have a mistake that it has no, it cannot be minus total discount, it has to be less total discount. Okay. So let's see. Definition of the mathematical model. Minimize total cost. I have commented this line because sometimes I want to run the mathematical model just with this dummy objective function. Yes, so subject to objective function, total cost equal to this minus this. And you see that here I open these curly brackets, I need to close it. So, I think that this is the one frame of this. Yes. Guys, we're ready to start revising the equations. Let me run this to see what happened. Good. Something happened. I like it. Let me see. This is the generated file. I can see here all the terms associated to the objective function. Good. I can have a quick revision. This is too long, but I can have a quick revision. I'm gonna pause a second. I need to go to the toilet.